I used to work as a substitute teacher because apparently I felt I wasn't getting nearly enough disrespect in life. Do you have any idea what it does to your self-esteem when a kid in a fanny pack calls you a fag? Laughed a little too hard at that. I feel like lowers your self-esteem. You learn things when you substitute teach. For instance, I recently learned that if you try writing in cursive for the first time in 10 years, you feel pretty retarded. Mr. Baril, do you have Parkinson's? That's mean. That's mean. Take a break. I also learned the importance of always wearing your name tag on the job, because that's the only difference between being an actual teacher retrieving a student and just some random dude telling a child they need to come with them to learn a lesson. Turns out nothing spoils snack time faster than a little accidental stranger danger. When people find out that I subbed, they want to know what classes I've been in. And to be truthful, I've been in most of them. Math, science, music. One day I spent a half day in German, and that was pretty fun. We listened to techno for 20 minutes and invaded the French class. Yeah. Those kids did not see that coming. Pourquoi? Pourquoi? Means why. Then, of course, are the days where I got to leave the building entirely. That's right, substitute teacher on a field trip. Let's take that shit show on tour. Let me see if I got this straight. I'm the only adult responsible for herding 25 kids, I don't know, through Valley Fair in 2 hours on Kids Ride Free Day? May as well go ahead and call in that Amber Alert now. Younger grades are my favorite, man, because they're just learning what words mean, the forms of words, kinds of words. That's always fun. Except sometimes they can accidentally get way too real. For instance, one time I was subbing in a first grade class, and this kid came up to me and asked me if he could have a dollar. And I said that I didn't have any cash on me. So then he asked if that meant I was broken. Which sent me into a 3-day spiral of self-reflection. Holy shit! You guys ever have a kid in a Transformers t-shirt scamper up to you out of nowhere and cut you to the fucking core like that? No! You don't see that coming. You're busy planning an activity on the snapping turtle for the afternoon, then Tiny Freud pops in, drops a bombshell, and hey, can't remember the last time you were truly happy. Oh, that's frustrating. It's a frustrating afternoon. It's good therapy, though. I now see that kid once a week. Yeah, we meet in his treehouse. He charges $4. Hell of a deal. Hell of a deal. I just lie in his beanbag chair, and he asks me why for a half hour. It's pretty good. It's pretty good. Pretty good. Pretty good therapy. Kindergarten's probably my favorite grade. The reason I love kindergarten so much is kindergartners are 1,000 times more happy to see me than I am to actually be me. It's like the best antidepressant in the world, right? They worship you. You're an adult. They think everything you do is amazing because they don't know any better. It's like being the ruler of North Korea. Except no one's hungry and most of them can read. So there are like a few differences, but like they're still... So. But even that's not always fun in games. There was one day where I was sexually harassed by a pair of kindergarten girls. Oh, it happens. No one talks about it. It happens. Awkward as hell, but it happens. Sexual harassment. Straight up sexual harassment. No shame. Smack my butt. Play with my hair. Made me feel like every office secretary from the 1950s. Every time I told them to knock it off, they just giggled and took another pull off their milk carton like it was a vodka tonic at 10 in the morning. No respect. My last name is Baril, and they call me Mr. Blueberry just to fuck with me. It's like they were a pair of, like, 70-year-old condo widows, and I was the pool boy that had to teach them how to spell orange. Like, that was... But I couldn't rat them out. Like, that wasn't a conversation I wanted to have with the principal. How are they acting, Robert? I don't know. Is there a word for baby cougar? Because two of whatever that would be, I guess. I've subbed in a lot of school districts, you guys, in my life, and not once have I ever seen a fit athletic director. Don't get me wrong, sweet guys, great guys, but 300, 400 pounds? I mean, do they even interview for that job, or does the superintendent just go to the nearest Buffalo Wild Wings and award it to who's ever breathing the heaviest? You don't look like you lived to 48. You want a gig? Yeah, sure, I'll take the gig.